The TARDIS. A little blue box from the 1960s on the outside. A whole other world on the inside. It's where the Doctor lived. All on his own, his magical place. It was a time machine. He could go anywhere. He took me to see who built the pyramids. To see how robots got their rights on a planet called Stowe. And I learnt the space police wore rhinos and big masks. But then it all ended. The event that apocalypsed. That's where his journey ended. And I'm gonna tell you this story. The story of the Doctor's death.
The TARDIS was just, well, drawn here.
Like it was drawn to Cleopatra's bedroom.
You're not going to let me forget about that, are you?
Nope.
So, we've landed in the Queen's Palace?
Posh, isn't it?
And it's 21st century?
It's a home year of 2020. Something's wrong.
Very perceptive. Doctor.
Oh, hello. You know me?
Oh, yes. I've been waiting for you. And his companion, Emma Murphy. You both met 2 months ago during the Yeti invasion. You're probably wondering how I know so much about you.
I am a bit, yeah.
Allow me to introduce myself. Maxion. Mr. Maxion to you. Businessman extraordinaire. Saviour of the human race.
Great. We've landed in a mentalist living room.
No, Emma. You have been travelling with the Doctor. You've missed it.
Missed what?
You're going to be gutted. You missed it, Doctor. The end of the world. The apocalypse.
What happened?
It was 6 a.m. Mother Nature went berserk, basically. Tornadoes strong, winds, flooding all over the world. Apocalypse. This is the Apocalypse Hotel. The place which contains over 4 million survivors. We choose them because of their past experiences with aliens. That's how we are narrowed down to our choices of who lived and who died.
Hold on. If you knew about this, why didn't you do anything to stop it?
We couldn't. We could only take in those 4 million. And I think, Doctor, we might have somebody you might be interested in. Violet Riley?
Violet?
She's been one of our oldest residents. Miss Riley has spent 15 years with Apocalypse.
15 years? You mean to tell me she's been here since 2005? It can't be. That's when I last left her here.
Who's Violet?
Oh, an old travelling companion of mine. She was brilliant, but, well, I left her.
You left her?
My life was too dangerous. I told you that when I first met you.
Oh my God!
What have you done to her?
She was working for Apocalypse in the early days, back in 2004. Then she met you. We wanted the Doctor to be here after the Earth was destroyed. She kept notes on your travels. She told us everything about you. But it wasn't enough. We installed her into a computer. We've got her memories on screen.
We've taped your adventures with her, Doc.
That's sick.
It was what we needed to do. She was keeping all those secrets from you.
Violet?
She can't speak. She's lost that ability when we connected her. Her thoughts appear on the computer, though.
That poor girl.
I know.
Her soul was ripped out and stored on her computer.
I know.
Can't you go back in time? Save Violet, save the world! Use the TARDIS, go back in time!
It makes no difference. It's already happened. We're already part of events.
But you're the Doctor. The man with the answer to everything.
No. Not this time.
What are you going to do?
What do you mean?
Are you going to stay? Or leave?
What on earth was that?
It's coming from outside.
You know, for such an organized company, Apocalypse obviously haven't done their homework on me.
Over there, on the other side of the Thames.
That's a business ship. Sort of like when you move into a new home and get it checked out. That's what these do. They belong to Quiggles and Co.
Quiggles and Co?
The biggest business in the universe. They invest in taking over other planets and sell them off to scavengers. You know, I don't think Mother Nature destroyed the Earth. I think Apocalypse did.
I know that... Never mind.
Go on.
Well, I know it's all going mental out there, but... My wife... She's just had a kid. I'm so scared. What if they're dead?
I'm not gonna lie to you, mate, it's likely. But we're here to help out, it's our job.
They knew that all this was going to happen. They even knew what day it was going to happen. But they didn't tell us. We should have asked more questions.
We're here on Her Majesty's service.
But we're not, though, are we? The Queen of England isn't in here, is she? She's out there, along with the rest of the world. She's probably dead. They can't escape, they're just like everybody else. Who are we working for now, huh? If there's no royal family, then who are we working for?
You did well. You had to shoot him. He was doubting our motives. The Doctor has found out, and I need you to help me take him.
TARDIS isn't working. What a surprise. We're leaving. Now!
I don't think so, Doctor. We tried to be pleasant with you. We welcomed you to our hotel and treated you with luxury. But you were rude and you opened our shutters. You're a man of the universe, Doctor. You found us out.
We only needed your TARDIS. It'll add value to the investors' interest of this dull planet. Goodbye, Doctor. I hope this cell is comfortable enough.
Now, what's that I hear?
Oh, what are you?
You're beautiful. You're heartbroken.
What is it?
I think it's human.
But it's clearly not.
Or at least it used to be.
What do you mean?
There were rumors that Quiggles and Co. sort of, well, experimented on the inhabitants of the planets they stole. It was never proved, of course, but there were still protesters and riots.
Why do they experiment?
Apocalypse needs workers. Big, bulky workers. They've designed the perfect slave.
Doctor, there's more. Over there.
They're in prison with us because they're in storage, waiting to work on the Quiggles and Co. home planet.
I wonder if we're next.
Well, We know that's not going to happen.
Ha!
You'd think they'd have taken this off me by now. Spaceships, monsters, wars, and demons can get in my way, but not a locked door. We're setting them all free.
Come on, you guys!
What the hell was that? Was it the alarm?
We've only got a few more minutes. Maxim will have heard the alarm and be on his way. God, apocalypse has got communication.
It's time to call the police.
What use are the police gonna be?
Space police, Emma. The Judoon. Send a message up to Violet. She'll boost it and send it out to the nearest Judoon fleet. Thank you, Violet. Maxim putting a bomb to the company's computer was a very big mistake.
Stop rattling on. You said you only had a few minutes.
Just using the TARDIS to send off the red alert. The more distress we send, the quicker they'll arrive.
I see you found our slaves.
Not slaves. People.
Not anymore. They're drones. Slaves. Bodies.
Well, I'll make sure they never just that.
Stop the distress! The TARDIS power is down. Nice try, Doctor. Your TARDIS has stopped boosting the signal. The Judoon won't arrive for at least a few weeks now. By that time, you'll be dead. We'll have sold this little planet, and the Judoon will be someone else's problem.
But it'll all come back to Apocalypse.
No. Quiggles and Co. are shutting down. Earth was our final conquest. You won't ruin this. Soldier, shoot him! Oh, and her.
Hello, darlings!
Oh, good God, not you!
Emma? Doctor! What a surprise! You're looking fabulous!
Who is this woman?
I'm him! I'm the Doctor! But a clone! A classy lady indeed!
Oh, Doctor! You've arrived just in time!
Well, I'm glad to know I wasn't tardy with the TARDIS. So, what seems to be the trouble here?
Guards! Shoot her!
I got pulled in by a distorted distress signal. Thought I'd have a nosy. Had no idea you two were here, though. I tell you, you're always getting into trouble.
Hurry up! Use your TARDIS.
Oh, impatient, isn't he? Signal set.
Ah!
Bring it!
You have ruined everything! You won't get away with this!
Neither will you. The Judoon are here. Fast, aren't they?
Desperate times! Desperate measures! Scavenger! Fire!
Blow, crow, blow, so, blow, blow, blow.
There's your man, Mr. Maxion.
Head of Quiggles & Co., Destroyer of Planets and Galactic Ripoff Merchant.
Charge, selling and trading of uncopyrighted planets. Attack of Judoon Fleet Force. Banishment execution.
Humans! Get inside my TARDIS! We're going to take you home.
This tower shall be demolished. Everyone evacuate.
Come on, Doctor. They're blowing this place up.
Emma, I can't leave. You know that.
Violet.
Yes. She's all alone. It's my fault she's here. I can't leave her to die like that. I'm going to unwire her and take her back in my TARDIS.
Will you have enough time?
delicious meat.
Yes.
You promise you'll make it?
I'll meet you on the outside. I'll park the TARDIS where we first started travelling together. Outside King's Cross Subway?
And what if you don't come?
The female doctor is waiting. Go! I'll be there, I promise.
You better be there. Or else I'll bloody kill you.
Good luck, darling.
Seven minutes.
I'm here. I'm going to unplug you and give you your life back.
King's Cross. When we first met, he's going to meet me here.
King's Cross it is. Here we are.
The doctor promised me he'll be here.
Only 2 minutes left. You'll make it. We're too late. Years of travelling and it ends in an elevator. I've witnessed 8 world wars, escaped a burning tunnel, and witnessed the end of the world. Twice. But here it is. The end. Still, could have been worse. I could have fallen over a brick. Oh. This is me using humour to cover my fear. I've always done it. And now here I am. A minute away from death, and I'm doing it again. But, Violet, I'm so glad I'm not dying alone. I'm glad you're here. I can't help but think, if I never took you inside the TARDIS, you wouldn't be here. You'd be out there, like Emma. God. I'm so scared. But I'm ready.
No! I'm going to wait here. All night if I have to. He said he'd meet me here. He will be here.
Honey, I think he's gone.
The doctor doesn't do dying. He'll be in his TARDIS right now with Violet. He won't have left her alone. He's just a little late, that's all. You know what he's like with that TARDIS of his.
I did wait for 7 hours, but he never came. And that's when I realised that he didn't make it out in time. He was too late. And now, 2 years later, the Earth has rebuilt itself. Those chosen survivors were evacuated by the Judoon, and now they're repopulating the planet. I'm part of a group, the Doctor's Companion Group. Sarah Jane Smith, Martha Jones, Sir Brigadier Lethbridge Stewart, they founded it with me. Some of his old companions think it's wrong to tell everyone about the Doctor. And we respect that. We're not getting paid to spread the word. But if we learn one thing from the Doctor, it's that this tiny little universe is massive. We have so much to see and so much to do. Not just in the universe, but on Earth alone. We've got a life, and the Doctor taught everyone he met to live it. And that's what we're all doing. We've survived the apocalypse. We've got years ahead of us. And the Doctor isn't dead. Oh no. Because he's a time traveller. He'll be out there in his TARDIS. He could even be out there right now. Because you know what? He'll always be out there. We'll always be back.